What's up, everyone? My name is Sal Sincotta. I am a wedding and portrait photographer and Canon Explorer of Light. And today I'm going to give you an inside peek into what's in my bag. Right out of the gate, EOS R5. Huge, huge fan of the improvements that Canon has made. And I can't say enough about it. This is a workhorse. So the R5 we're using in full production, we use it for our weddings, we use it for our portraits, and I just love the quality of the files that are coming off the camera. I want healthy skin tones, that matters. You can only fix so much in post. You want a solid raw file, you want good color. So we set these up for custom. You can tweak all the buttons to work the way you want. Again, if we're talking about what I'm using on any given day that I'm working, I love having the extended battery grip. To me, that's very important to be able to go vertical with the camera and not have to be this way with it. So I really like to be able to work here, right? You're working long hours, I wanna have that. Right here to my right is the Holy Trinity. If you are a wedding photographer and you're like, what glass do I need in my bag? These three lenses are where you wanna start. So right out of the gate, we have the Canon RF 1535 LISUSM lens. And so with the 1535, right, you've got this wide angle lens that you're working with, and this is at the bottom end of the range, so it's that wide angle part. So if you want those big architectural shots inside the church, the big dramatic landscapes, this is a must-have lens in your bag. And this is f2.8, right? So it's fast glass, it's their L series, and it's gonna give you a nice opening range, right? All the way up to 200 millimeters. So we'll talk about that in the trinity of lenses. And so next up, right, in the mid-range here is the Canon 2870 f2.0 L series USM lens as well. And so, right, again, another RF lens, but this one's big, right? So for to get f2 in the 2870 range, it is just beautiful. The images that you're gonna create off this lens, I can't say enough about it, moving to the RF glass. So it's absolutely beautiful, a little heavy, but you get used to it, right? I mean, I'll take the heavy for that extra stop of light, right? I wanna be at 2.0, beautiful, great range. And at the 70 millimeters, you're starting to get closer to what a portrait lens would be, right? You don't wanna take portraits at 35 millimeters, portraits at 15 millimeters, everything is skewed at that point. So I like having this, I can work in close quarters without skewing everything. So think about bridal prep, think about groom prep. This gives you that range where you can be in the room, be close to the bride, but still not skew everything and still get that beautiful shallow depth of field that you're gonna want, right? So this is a must have, it's the middle of the range. Final lens in the Holy Trinity here is the Canon RF 7200 L series ISUSM lens. And so with this particular one, they've done a great job on the RF series, right? If you're used to the EF lenses, much larger, much heavier. And so this at f2.8 is also another workhorse for me. So if I had to, pick a lens that I'm using all the time or a majority of the time, the 7200 is absolutely the workhorse for me, right? It's not gonna get super wide at 70 millimeters, but at 200, we're gonna compress that background. I can zoom in, I can get a nice portrait, and at 2.8, beautiful, shallow depth of field that you're gonna get, and it makes a difference. Look, these three lenses, as far as I'm concerned, are a must-have for any wedding photographer that's getting started. I think this is what you have to have in your bag to produce a professional event for your clients. But how do we up our games as photographers? And when I say up our games, I'm not talking about just the creative piece of it. The focal length you choose will also make a difference, right? So these lenses will take you through a range, but they're never going to be the same, look the same as a prime lens. And so when it comes to primes, right, the first lens that I like to have in my bag is a RF 50 millimeter f1.2 L-series USM lens as well. And so why I like this lens so much is because of the speed, right? At f1.2, it's so milky. that background, that shallow depth of field, everything blurs, your subject pops off the background when you shoot wide open. And again, it just, you get what you pay for with this kind of stuff. So this to me is another must-have lens. I wouldn't get super close to people for portraits, but this is a great mid-range lens where you could step back, you step back, right? There's no zooming on a prime lens. You're the zoom. You've got to move in, you've got to move out, and move your feet through your scene. And that's fine, because the pro of it is you're gonna get this beautiful kind of open shot. Canon just released an RF version of this, but this is the EF 100 millimeter macro F2.8 L-series ISUSM. The IS stands for image stabilization. So whenever you can have a little bit extra stabilization in the lens and camera system, it's just gonna make for sharper images. Now, this does have an RF adapter on it for you so that you can use it on your, the R-series cameras. But what I will say is Canon just released, and I reviewed it, the RF version of the 100 macro. You're gonna want that one. But this is what's in my bag right now until they release that. Now, why do you need a lens like this? This is all about detail shots. So you're gonna want, when you want that close-up shot of the ring, that close-up shot of the earring, any of those details, you want a macro lens so you can get super close to your subject. But I will tell you, the must-have that I can't live without, okay, is the Canon RF 85 millimeter F1.2 L-series USM lens. Now, I'm obsessed with this lens. At 1.2, it is tack sharp. Tack sharp, especially when you connect it with the features of the RF, the EOS R5. When you connect it with those features, right, and I'm talking about the eye detection, follow focus, that type of stuff, it's not gonna miss. At 85 millimeter, this is the perfect portrait lens. This is the lens I use when I'm doing headshots, when I'm doing high school senior portraits, when I'm doing bridal portraits, groom portraits. This is the lens I'm switching to. And again, at 1.2, it's just beautiful. It's beautiful on the skin. It blurs out that background, allows your subject to pop off the background. And so this is an absolutely perfect lens to have in your bag. So, if you like this video, give me a like down below and subscribe to the Canon YouTube channel. I think you're gonna enjoy future videos. And I really do hope this inspires you to go out there and grow your bag and make some incredible images.